Them out. But our people so oppressed, you know what I'm saying? They try anything, they do anything, and it's all lust. It's all the covetous spirit. Yeah. It's time for our people to wake up, repent, and keep the commandments of God. Yeah. Every year I come out here, I see my people doing the same thing. I see my sisters dressed the same way. I see young girls, babies out here. You can't tell a decent young lady from a street hoe. It's the truth. It's the truth. Every year, the same thing. It's time for our people to wake up and keep the commandments of God. Give me that real quick, Isaiah 52, verse 1. For real, though, man, we tired of this. Ain't y'all tired of the conditions in your community? Ain't y'all tired of the killing going on? Ain't y'all tired of it? For real, ain't you tired of the STD rate being high in your communities? If you tired of it, guess what? You got to change this first. Your mind got to be changed. Our people say they won't change. You won't change in the community, but you won't change nothing about you. It's time for our people to wake up. Read what you got.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 52 and verse 1. Awake, awake.
You hear that? This is what God asking our people to do in Chicago. Awake, awake. Wake up! I guarantee you some people gonna die today. Some people gonna die tonight. It is what it is. You wanna know why some people gonna die? Because they won't take heed to the word of God. A lot of our people gonna die because they won't take heed to the word of God and they won't repent. Read that again.
Awake! Awake!
God is asking you to wake up. Why? Because you are the Israelites the Bible speaks of. You out here at the Bud Billiken Parade. Do you know what a Billiken is? Do you know what the Bud Billiken is? It is a Buddha, a Chinese Buddha. This is idolatry right here. That's another problem with our people. Give me that in Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 11. That's another problem with our people, man. You out here in the midst of idolatry right now. You don't even know who your God is. You got people down there got Christians set up. That's another idol. These idols, it's idols running rapid through our communities. Hell, we Muslims, we Christians, hell, we Moors, we everything on the planet Earth but what God wants us to be. And we wonder why our neighborhood's destroyed. Read what you got.
This is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 2 and verse 11.
Bring it out.
Have a nation changed their gods?
Say, have a nation changed their gods? Have a nation changed their gods? No. The Chinese man, he still worship his Billiken or his Buddha. The East Indians still worship their Krishna. The Arabs still worship the cobblestone. It say, have the nation changed their god? Read on.
Which are yet no gods?
They ain't no gods, though. They don't exist. It's all idolatry. And look, that's what our people love. We love to be entertained, man. We love entertainment. That's why a lot of our people gonna die. A lot of our people gonna die because you hate the word of God and you love entertainment. Entertainment has become an idol to our people. Shaking your ass is an idol to you wanna see people shake their boots. Our young girls out here right now, look at the way they dress. Look at our young men dancing out in the feminine. We're supposed to be God's chosen people, and look how God chose to be back. All we do is entertain. That's what we want to do, just entertain, man. For real. And we more than just entertainers. Real.
But thy people have changed their glory, but that which doth not crumble. Have a nation changed their God, which are yet no God?
They have a nation changed their gods without yet no God. They ain't changed their gods, but listen, read.
But my people have changed their glory for that which doth not profit.
It said, but my people have changed their glory for that which has not profit. Bad Billiken don't profit us. Why has this parade profit us every year? These people that dancing in the street, they ain't getting no money. They ain't getting no college, they ain't getting no scholarships for doing this. All they doing is entertaining. It's time for our people to wake up and repent, man. God is trying to call our people back into the sheepfold. Give me that in Isaiah chapter 3, Isaiah chapter 1, verse 5. And look at that young man. All that young man do is dance in feminine. For real, read what you got. Isaiah 1 and 5, read.
Why should you
start at 4?
Verse 4. Ah, sinful nation.
The Most High God is talking to you. He said, ah, sinful nation. Why is we a sinful nation? Because we don't keep the commandments. We love idolatry. We love adultery. We love covetousness. We love stealing. We love robbing. Hell, we even hate one another. We the only people on the planet Earth that hate each other. For real. Think about what happened in Chicago the last 2 weeks. The last week. Well, over 100 shootings. 50 people dead. That's hatred right there. That's hatred for each other. And on top of that, now the white man coming into your communities, he's shooting you down. You know why he's shooting you down? Because you shoot each other down. And then he's like, hey, look, they shoot each other down. They don't care. So I'm going to come to their communities. I'm going to kill them too. You got white men putting on black faces, acting like black men shooting you down in your communities. Why? Because then you do it to each other. So they think you don't care about each other. They're like, hey, let me just throw on a black face. Let me go kill them too. Read.
Ah, sinful nation.
Say, ah, sinful nation. Who the Most High talking about? He talking about us. He talking about you. We the Israelites. Read.
A people laden with iniquity.
He said we laden with iniquity. That's why a lot of our people gonna die. A lot of our people gonna die because they think this a joke. They laugh at the brothers in the purple and gold. This funny to them until people get the shoe. Shoot, get the break out. I guarantee you, a bunch of people gonna run towards the brothers in the purple and gold. Cause you're gonna be looking for protection. A shoot break out right now, everybody gonna be screaming for God. But right now, God is calling you right now. You know what I'm saying? A fight break out, you're gonna be screaming for God. But God is calling you right now to repent and come into the sheepfold. So guess what? When you get your judgment when they start shooting, and you get hit by a bullet, remember God was calling you to the sheepfold. Because the way they shooting up in Chicago, I'll guarantee you, one of you, any one of you could be next out here. And understand that's the judgment of God. Read on.
Read again. Ah, sinful nation.
He said, ah, sinful nation, read.
A people laden with iniquity.
You say our people is laden with iniquity. You covered with sin. Read on.
A seed of evildoers.
He said we are seed of evildoers. We love doing evil. He said we wise to do evil, but to do good we'll know. We wise to do evil, man. But to do good we'll know how to do good. Read on.
Children that are corruptors.
He said we are children that are corruptors. Everything we do, we corrupted. Everything we do, we corrupt it. Why? Because we got no knowledge of God. We got no knowledge of self. Our people don't even know who they are. Everything that was taught to you was taught to you by your slave master. Everything that was taught to us, it was taught to us by another nation of people. Even the Bible. The Bible was taught. That's why our people worship the white man as God. Don't y'all know we the only people on the planet Earth that worship another man as our God? We the only people on the planet Earth that worship a God that don't look like us. The white man ain't Jesus Christ. They're the damn devil the Bible speaks of. It is what it is. You can tell by their actions that they're the devil. Tell me what one good thing they've done since they've been on the planet Earth. They ain't done nothing right. This land, they in possession of stolen property right now. They're first and foremost, they're in possession of the land. They're in possession of you, because you ain't come from here. They brought you over here on cargo slave ships. But our people don't want to change, though. And since we don't want to change, that's what's going to happen. You're going to die right here in the streets of Chicago. Somebody going to gun you down. That's for sure. You're going to get gunned down. Why? Because you don't want to change. You don't want to repent. You're going to be next. I guarantee you, you're next. If you don't repent. I apologize, brother. Let's read.
They have forsaken the Lord.
You say they have forsaken the Lord. You know why? You want to know why you're going to be next to get gunned down? Just like I seen a video on the internet the other day. Somebody just come through. Whole crowd of people running. Whole crowd of people running. You're going to be next. Why you going to be next? Why you going to be one of the next people to get gunned down? Read that again.
They have forsaken the Lord.
Because you've forsaken the Lord. That's why you're going to be next to be gunned down in Chicago. Because you have forsaken the Lord. Read on.
They have provoked the Holy One of Israel.
Because you keep provoking God. Like today is the Lord's Sabbath day. The Lord said no buying, no selling, no cooking, no cleaning. No working. What are people doing? Buying, selling, cooking, cleaning, working. Rioting, reveling. That's what we're doing on the Lord's Sabbath day. So when somebody get gunned down out here, remember, you forsake the Holy One of Israel. You constantly provoking God. God constantly keep trying to call you, but you don't want to repent. You go to these Christian churches on Sunday, the pastor ain't teaching you nothing. You don't even know who you are. Everything that was taught to you was talked to you by another race of people. Read on.
They have provoked the Holy One of Israel.
You keep provoking God. Our people don't love God. How many people out here love God? What are people at? What are lovers of the Lord at? If you love the Lord, come on and step up and profess your Lord love for the Lord. For real though, step up. Don't just raise your hand up. Don't just say I do. You gotta show the Lord you love him. Can you get the Lord a hug? Can you give God a hug? Can you give him a gift? Can you give him a card? So how do you show your love for God? Do you know how to show your love for God? Because all our people do is talk off at the mouth. God got commandments in his Bible. You constantly break them. And you, when you break God's commandments, you make them angry. If you love somebody, you ain't going to constantly make them angry. It's time for y'all to repent. Read on.
They have provoked the Holy One of Israel.
It said they have provoked the Holy One of Israel. Remember, if a riot break out here today, it's because you provoked the Holy One of Israel. Why? Because you're stealing this idolatry called Billiken. Bad Billiken. Read.
They have provoked the Holy One of Israel unto anger. They are going away backwards.
He said, you're going away backwards. You ain't going towards the Most High. Everything you do out here today, you're going backwards from the Lord. How many of y'all out here know God? Who knows the Lord? You have people raise your hand up, but God said you don't know him. You don't know him because you don't keep his commandments. Read on.
Why should you be stricken anymore?
The Lord said, why should I keep stricken you? Why should I keep shooting you down in the streets? Because you're going backwards. A lot of our people don't want to repent. Read on.
Why should you be stricken anymore? Ye will revolt more and more.
You will revolt more and more. Every time everything that happens to our people revolt more and more. You revolt more and more.
We gotta go to the parties at. We gotta go where they have their things at. We gotta go everywhere where these black young men is at so we can stop them from killing each other.
You're right. We need to go everywhere where our young men at and stop them and teach them. You gotta teach them. You gotta change their minds. I'm gonna show you something, bro. Hey, listen to this. Give me Romans 12. How we gonna stop the young men from Chicago from killing each other? How's we gonna do that? Because I'm gonna tell you, this whole system has been set up against us. This whole system has set up to keep you oppressed, set up to keep you adulterous, set up to keep you idolaters, set up to keep you covetous. This whole system has been set up to destroy you. So how we gonna change our men, young Wayne? Read.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 12 and verse 2. And be not conformed to this world.
We got to teach our young men that, look, hey, this world that you're in now, you're in the matrix. It's time for you to wake up. Because y'all are in the matrix out here. Everybody doing the same damn thing. The only people that's out here different right now is the people in purple and gold. Everybody else doing the same thing. You're in the midst of idolatry, join the Billiken. You got a culture vulture right there. This damn white dude think he a monk. Down the street, you got another white dude think he a Krishna. Hey, over there in Israel, they think they Israelites. I'm telling you, man, it's time for us to wake up. For real, though. This dude ain't no damn monk. For real, he the damn devil the Bible speaks of. See what you got.
And be not conformed to this world.
God said, don't be conformed to this world. You have been conformed to this world. If you see Alicia Keys wear green hair, you wear green hair. If you see Beyonce wear blonde hair, you wear blonde hair. It's time for our people to wake up, man. For real, though. Everything you see an entertainer do, you do. For real, though. If people start walking around naked, guess what you're going to start doing? If Beyonce said, look, I'm going to walk around naked every day. This the new style. Then Alicia Keys do it. Then Rihanna do it. Then what's another one there? Keisha Cole do it. Next thing you know, you'll start walking around naked.
That's right.
For real though. Time for our people to wake up, man. Read what you got.
And be not conformed to this world.
That's why we're in so much sin, because you're conformed to the world. Whatever your idols do, whatever these entertainers do, you do it. If these entertainers sag the pants off their ass, You sagged the pants off your butt. I remember back in the days when I was coming up, skinny jeans wasn't a thing. Skinny jeans, now our people wear the tightest, littlest jeans you can find. For real though, you want nut huggers. Nut huggers, balls twisting all up together. For real though, we ain't wear that when we was young. For real though, our sisters wear the most provocative things on the planet Earth. And I'ma tell some of y'all sisters something. Believe it or not, we love y'all. A lot of y'all don't got no real friends. Cause some of the stuff you coming out the house with on, you look a damn disgrace. You look pitiful. And you ain't supposed to look like that. You the son, we the sons and the daughters of the living God. But your friend won't tell you, hey, you don't need to be putting that on. You shape four, five different ways, girl. You need to put a big long dress on and cover up. Your homeboy won't tell you, hey, bro, them jeans too damn skinny. Right. You know what I'm saying? Your pants sagging off your butt. Right. Gay people walking around. Well, I'm going to tell you young men something. You got all these gay people walking around. You sagging your pants off your butt. The gay dude looking at your butt saying, yeah, he nice. Right. He saying, yeah, you look good. Right. He saying, yeah, I want that. He said, yeah, he advertising that pretty good. But guess what you do? You keep showing it to him. You advertise it too. You still sag it up off your ass. And then I'm going to tell you what it was really a trip. This was really a trip right here. This is a real trip right here. Some of y'all got belts on, and you still sag your pants off your ass. But guess what? The gay homosexual dude looking at you, he whistling like, hey, whistle, bro. I can't whistle. That's how the hell he whistling at you. He looking at your ass talking about, yeah, he thick. He nice. Look at that. Tell y'all to wake up and repent. Read that again.
And be not conformed to this world.
It said, be not conformed to this world. Quit following the world. Because you haven't been conformed to this world. Read.
But be ye transformed.
God asking you to be transformed in what?
By the renewing of your mind.
The Lord wants you to renew your mind. It's time for you to renew your mind.
That's right.
It's amazing how our young women sitting up there turning to bull daggers. For real, dressing up like men, wrapping their titties up. You know, guess what? I'm going to tell you something, sister. You ain't a man. You still have your period at the end of the month. You still get your period once a month. You ain't no man, man. For real, if God wanted you to be a man, he would have created you to be a man. The same thing with men. You got some men tucking their penis. You walk around with your damn penis tucked. You ain't no damn woman. Guess what, bro? At the end of the day, when you sit up there and you go home, it's going to flop out. It's going to untuck. It's going to untuck. You ain't no damn woman. It's time, y'all, give me that in Romans 1 and 26. You got to renew your mind. The white man taught you this lasciviousness. For real, though, you following the ways of Rome. You following the ways of the Grecians. Time for y'all to wake up. Look, I'm coming out here to tell y'all the truth, man. Look, I tried to sit back and be quiet. It's too late now. I'm up here now. I'm just going to let you know the business, man. For real, though. For real, you ain't no damn man. You ain't no woman. That homosexuality got to stop in our community. I'm going to tell you why. If man being with man and woman being with woman, how in the hell can we procreate? First and foremost, we killing each other. The damn white man killing us. And then now you sit up there and say, well, hey, I like another man. And hey, I like another woman. How in the hell we going to have kids and procreate? Tell y'all to wake up and repent, man. Give me that in Romans 1 real quick. They prophesied about that. Read.
Romans chapter 1 and verse 26. For this cause, God gave them up unto vile affection.
Homosexuality is vile affection in our community. He said, I gave them up to vile affections. Read on. He said, it's vile. That means it's disgusting. A man let another man run up in him is disgusting. A woman sucking another woman's, vagina is disgusting. Read.
For even their woman did change their natural youth.
You know, they say even our women change their natural youth. A woman's supposed to get with a man and have kids. That's natural. You don't see two male dogs trying to get on each other. You don't see two female dogs digging each other. That's against nature. But guess what? You follow the white man, whatever the white man do, you do. Read up.
For even their women did change their natural youth.
They say even their women did change their natural youth. Read up. And then you go get a damn scrap on and walk around like you hanging. You ain't hanging nothing. You ain't hanging. For real though. Wake the hell up. Don't you see that that's inordinate affection? That's vile. That's disgusting.
For even their women did change their natural youth into that which is against nature.
You hear that? That is against nature. Women being with women is against nature. Men being with men is against nature. Read on.
And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the women.
He's saying the men do the same thing. They leave the natural use of a woman. Why? Man and woman supposed to get married. God created Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve. Read on.
Burn in their lust.
You hear that? He said burn in their lust. Man with man is you burning in your lust. You had a thought come in your head one day. I wonder what it's like to be with my best friend. And then one day you ended up in the room with your best friend, drunk and high, and now y'all doing it. Doing some vile, disgusting stuff. But your nasty ass.
Burn in their lust, one toward another.
You say burn in your lust, one towards another. Read on.
Men with men.
You say men with men. Do read on.
Working that which is unseen.
You say working that which is unseen. It's not comely. It's not orderly. You know what I'm saying? It's vile. It's disgusting. Read on.
And receiving in themselves.
He said, receiving in themselves. Read on.
That recompense.
That recompense. What is that recompense, eh? That's that recompense, eh? What's that recompense? What's the name of that cancer they get in the booty? The butt cancer. Colon cancer. That's that recompense that you receive. Read on.
And receiving in themselves that recompense of their error.
Of their error. What was the error? Man with man, woman with woman. That was the error. Read on.
And receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was me.
You say that recompense, which is meat. If man be with man, you should get AIDS. That's right for you. Because you shouldn't have got with another man. Tell about people to wake up and repent, man.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.